Dear students, today we are going to understand the method of finding derivatives of functions in parametric forms. A relation expressed between two variables x and y in the form x is equal to f of t, y is equal to g of t is said to be parametric form with t as a parameter. So before we start talking about the derivatives, let's understand that what do we mean by the parametric form actually. Here a circle with center 0, 0 and radius r is given. We know that the equation of this circle is given by x square plus y square is equal to r square. If we choose any general point on this circle, the coordinates of this point can be always taken as r cos theta comma r sin theta. How can we be sure about it? Let's consider LHS of this equation and substitute x as r cos theta and y as r sin theta. Open the squares and simplify. And since inside the bracket we get cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is equal to 1. So LHS is coming out equal to RHS. Therefore, x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta gives us the parametric form of a circle where theta is actually known as a parameter. I'm sure you all have resembled this figure. This is a standard ellipse. The equation of this ellipse is given by x square over a square plus y square over b square is equal to 1. A point a cos theta comma b sin theta represent any general point on it. Let's quickly verify. So consider LHS. As x is a cos theta and y is b sin theta, so substituting the values in LHS, and simplifying, we can easily observe that a square gets cancelled out, b square gets cancelled out, and we left again with 1, which is equal to RHS. So final conclusion, x is equal to a cos theta and y equal to b sin theta represents the parametric form of this ellipse where theta is a parameter. Similarly, when we talk about a parabola, this is a right parabola whose equation is given by y square is 4ax. You can easily observe that if I choose any point A on this, its coordinates can be taken as at square comma 2at, where t is now the parameter I leave this as a homework for you to verify that why this point A can be taken as a general point on this parabola. Similarly, this is hyperbola and whose equation is given by x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. I claim that any point on it A can be taken as A secant theta comma B tan theta. So x is equal to A secant theta and y equal to B tan theta represents the parametric form of a hyperbola where theta is a parameter. This is left as an exercise to verify that why it will work. Coming back to the derivatives. So derivatives of a functions in a parametric form, we have a simple formula. Dy by dx is given by dy by dt divided by dx by dt if in a given situation t is given as a parameter. And if it would have been theta, so in that case the formula for dy by dx will become dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. Based on this, let's start with few problems. First question: find dy by dx if x is equal to a cos theta and y is equal to a sin theta. Do remember a and b, whichever variables are given, so they are always constant. So the parameter here is theta. Let us find out dx by d theta, which is clearly a is constant and the derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. So this is minus a sin theta. Now y is equal to a sin theta. So this would give us dy over d theta as a cos theta. Now we have a simple formula. Dy by dx is equal to dy over d theta upon dx over d theta. Substituting the values, we get a cos theta divided by minus a sin theta, which simplifies to minus cot theta, which is our required answer. Let us consider one another example. Find dy by dx if x is equal to a t square and y is equal to 2at. Clearly a is a constant and t here is a parameter. So we will differentiate x with respect to t. We get a into the derivative of t square is 2t, so it's 2at. And for y, dy by dt is simply 2a. Now the formula for dy by dx is dy over dt, because the now the parameter is t, divided by dx by dt. substituting their values, 2a will get cancelled out and we left with 1 over t, which is our required answer. Consider another problem. Find dy by dx if x is equal to a times theta plus sin theta and y as a times 1 minus cos theta. So let's differentiate x with respect to theta. It is coming out equal to 1 plus cos theta. Similarly, when we differentiate y with respect to theta, we get a into sin theta, because the derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta, so negative negative will make it plus. Now dy over dx is given by dy over d theta upon dx over d theta, which is equal to a sin theta divided by a times 1 plus cos theta. So a will get cancelled with a and we get our required answer. But do remember, in 11th you have learned the method how to express the given expression in its simpler form. So it is expected that you simplify it further. So using some basic formulas, sin theta can be written as 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2 and 1 plus cos theta is a direct formula for 2 cos square theta by 2. So do revise all the formulas of trigonometry you did in class 11th and as well as in class 12th. So 2 will get cancelled with 2, 1 cos will get cancelled with cos theta by 2 and we left with sin theta by 2 divided by cos theta by 2, which is equal to tan theta by 2, which is your required answer. Coming to the next problem, if x is equal to a times cos t plus log of tan t by 2 and y is simple a sin t, you need to find dy by dx. So main is about finding out the derivative of x with respect to t. Clearly again t is a parameter. So this is equal to the derivative of cos t minus of sin t plus, to find the derivative of log of tan t by 2, we will be applying chain rule. So firstly, for log, it's 1 over tan t by 2. As we know, the derivative of log x is 1 by x into, now it's the turn of tan, and the derivative of tan x is secant square x by 2. So here in this case, it will be secant square t by 2 into finally t by 2, whose derivative will be 1 by 2. Let us now simplify it further. Changing tan to sin by cos, you can easily find it will reduce to cos t by 2 upon tan t by 2. secant square can be written as 1 upon cos square t by 2 into 1 by 2. Let's further solve it. 1 cos will get cancelled out and we left with 1 over 2 sin t by 2 cos t by 2. Remember, it is our direct formula which is given by sin t. Taking LCM, it's minus sin square t plus 1, and one can easily observe 1 minus sin square t is cos square t. That is, we have finally dx by dt with us, a cos square t upon sin t. Again, we are given with y as a sin t, whose derivative is very simple, a cos t. Now, let's write the formula for dy by dx, and it will be dy by dt divided by dx by dt. Substituting their values, dy by dt is a cos t, and dx by dt is calculated here, so which is a times cos square t divided by sin t. Simplify this, you can easily observe we get sin t divided by cos t, which is equal to tan t, your required answer. Consider another problem. If x is equal to a times cos theta plus theta sin theta, and y is equal to a times sin theta minus theta cos theta, of course we need to find dy over dx. So how we are going to start? X is given . Let's start differentiating this with respect to theta. So the derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta plus theta sin theta. How we are going to differentiate it? It's a product rule. So first, as it is, derivative of second plus second as it is derivative of first. When you open the bracket and simplify, you will find sin theta will get cancelled out and we left only with a theta cos theta. Now we are going to consider y. And differentiate this with respect to theta. The derivative of sin theta, simply cos theta. Now here it's minus sign outside, and it's again product rule. So how we are going to apply this product rule? First, as it is, derivative of second plus second as it is derivative of first. One can easily observe when you open the bracket, cos theta will cancel with cos theta and we left with a theta sine theta. Now we have the simple formula for dy by dx, dy over d theta upon dx over d theta. So this is equal to a theta sine theta divided by a theta cos theta. A theta will cancel out in numerator and denominator. We left with sin theta by cos theta, and which is finally equal to tan theta, which is our required answer. Consider another problem. One of the possible method is that you can directly differentiate this and get dx by dt. We can observe that t here is a parameter. Another possibility is you can take log both the sides and differentiate. Third possibility is you can square both the sides and then differentiate. You will get your required answer. But all these methods are little lengthier. So let me follow a very simple approach to solve this particular question. Let me call this as equation number 1 and this as our equation number 2. Multiply 1 and 2. So we get x into y is equal to root of a power sin inverse t into root of a power cos inverse t, which can be written as square root of a sin inverse t into a power cos inverse t. Using laws of exponent, if base are same, powers are added. What is sin inverse t plus cos inverse t? Recall, it's simply pi by 2. You already have learned in inverse trigonometry. That is, we have xy is equal to square root of a power pi by 2. Remember, RHS is constant. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. It's a product rule. First as it is derivative of second plus second as it is derivative of first, and it's equal to 0 because RHS is a constant and the derivative of constant is 0. So rearranging, we get dy over dx is minus y divided by x, and this is what we wanted to show, hence shown, which completes this question. Now it's your turn. Here is the home assignment. 5 questions are given to you. Please try them प्लीज सॉल्व देम. गुड लक टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टेक केयर.